What's up, everybody? Welcome to a new English bit. Today, we're going to learn 10 funny adjectives that will be very easy to remember. Are you ready to learn some new vocabulary? So take a notebook and let's get started. The first adjective is cheesy, long E, cheesy, like queso, and it means cursi. For example, the swan towel is so cheesy. The second adjective is corny. The pronunciation is long O, corny, like corn, and it means the same as cheesy, but it's more American. For example, he sent her such a corny Valentine postcard. Now let's move on to our third adjective, which is twee. The pronunciation is long E, twee. And it means too perfect. For example, the feed on her Instagram account is so twee. Number four is the adjective soppy, como sopa. And it means empalagoso. We can use it to talk about a film or a love song. For example, it's such a soppy love story. Que quiere decir que es un pastelón. Number five, the adjective tacky, which means hortera. For example, these gold bathroom accessories are so tacky. Our next adjective is flashy, like flash de la cámara, and it means llamativo. For example, his new car is very flashy. Our adjective number seven is fussy, and it has different meanings. It can mean quisquilloso, exigente, o tiquismiquis en cuanto a la comida. Let's look at some examples. She's so fussy. Everything has to be perfect in the house. Or, I'm not surprised you're still single. You're so fussy. Or another example, he's a fussy eater. Es un tiquismiquis en cuanto a la comida. Now, let's move on to our adjective number eight, which is punchy. To punch means dar un puñetazo, and the adjective punchy is con garra. For example, his speech was short but punchy. Our adjective number nine is touchy-feely, which means chobón, a person who enjoys touching and holding other people more than is usual. For example, he is a great guy but a bit touchy-feely. Our last adjective is wishy-washy, and it also has different meanings. It can mean indeciso, una persona sin carácter, o poco claro y confuso. And to finish on a good note, we're going to watch one example from one of my favorite series, Modern Family. Here, Mitch tells Cam how he came out of the closet to his grandmother, and he uses the adjective wishy-washy to mean that he wasn't direct or clear. And now, let's watch the excerpt.
She doesn't remember I'm gay.
Yeah, no, I know. I was here for the whole explanation.
This means I get to come out to her again. It was a disaster the first time. I was so wishy-washy about the whole thing that when I finally said, I think I might be gay, she said, ew.
So I really hope you enjoyed this English bit. Please let us know in the comments below which adjective is your favorite. Don't forget to like this video and to subscribe to our channel. With that being said, thanks for watching and see you next week. Ciao!